The bottom looks pretty flat, Dave, so anything we see that's different from flat is what we're kind of looking for.
9 a.m. The Triangle Research and Investigation Group is deep within the Bermuda Triangle, a treacherous stretch of ocean notorious for the unprecedented number of planes, ships, and people that have vanished there without a trace. They're using cutting-edge sonar to search the seafloor for a sunken dinghy. It may help answer one of the most famous riddles in Triangle history. What happened to the USS Cyclops?
You see anything on that sonar?
Not yet. Boy, you guys are putting pressure on me.
That's right.
We're looking for something that's pretty small that's gonna make it harder to find, because a lot of times it could be mistaken for just, you know, piles of rocks or something down there. Like looking for a needle in the haystack.
What's that? Right here. Look, here it is on 3D. That's it on the side sonar.
That's looking good.
Can we tell how big it is?
It's gonna be anywhere between 10 and 12 foot long, just how this is set up.
All right, I think we found it here, Dave.
The trig team has located an anomaly on the ocean floor in approximately 18 feet of water. If the find proves to be the target dinghy, they will attempt a dangerous and difficult procedure, raising the boat to the surface for further examination.
Hey, Mike, get me that buoy.
Yeah, I got it.
I'll throw it right on top.
Pretty sure it's over here.
I hope it's ours.
Well, there's one way to find out.
So our plan for the day is to get right in there, determine what we found, if it is in fact Mark's vessel, bring it up to the surface, see if it's been burned out, if the engine still is around or intact, anything that might validate Mark's explanation as to what happened to him.
For the guys on top, I need some lifting bags. Right off the bat, I'm gonna think about using two, one for the front, one for the back.
All right, so when the boat gets up to the top, what's our plan after that? Because that's usually when goes wrong.
As it's going up, stay away from the underside of anything that's going above you, because you don't want it coming back to you. If we find a motor, we have an alternate lift bag and bring it to the top separately.
Okay.
All right, let's get suited up and get wet.
Let's go. Got your leg.
So theoretically, this is what we do. We go down with line, airbags, a dive tank, and an inflator tube. We get to the bottom, we attach the dive bags at the front and the back end of the boat, and then we start inflating the lift bags.
All right.
The kind of evidence that we'd be looking for on the boat or the motor is gonna be burn marks, scarring, or maybe a short in the engine somewhere that caused a spark that could have ignited a methane gas cloud.
Okay, everybody set?
Going down.
Dave, can you hear me?
Topside, this is Dave. Over.
How's the visibility down there, guys?
Visibility's horrible, topside.
All right, guys, we got you loud and clear.
There it is. That looks like a boat. That is absolutely a boat, my friend. So this is a dinghy. The hull, the front cover looks like it got kind of blown apart. It's kind of just floating around here.
Yeah, roger that.
What's the condition of the hull?
Boat's pretty tore up. I mean, you can definitely tell something happened to it for the sake.
Yeah, roger that.
It's got an older model engine on it. It shows some signs of possibly a fire. It looks like the carburetor was blown right off this thing.
The back of that boat had enough trauma to it that it was actually pliable. You could move parts of it. The seams were actually cracked off the sidewalls.
Go ahead and see how secure that engine is. It doesn't look like it's gonna stay there. Let's do something with it.
The motor was so loose that I could snap it off the back of the dinghy. For me to be able to do it with just hand power definitely meant something catastrophic, you could say, happened.
Doctor, got the side, over. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna find a lifting point on the back of the boat here. We're gonna tie in this lifting bag, and then we're gonna tie it to the back side of the boat, and we're gonna tie one to the front side of the boat. You copy, Dave?
I copy.
Oh, It's got a good lifting eye. Now I'll start tying this off.
You know, raising a boat isn't the easiest thing. I mean, there's so many variables to go wrong. You got to get ropes underneath it.
I'll hook one of the hooks to the backside now, copy?
Roger that.
If you get wrapped up in that, you can't get out. It's like a Pandora's box. Anything could happen when you're down there.
Everything looks good to go. It's going to come up pretty dang quick because it's light right now, and I haven't even put air in the bag. Copy.
Hey, give us a little fair warning before she starts to lift.
All right, we'll just lift the front of the boat and see if it'll come up without any help.
Copy.
Coming up. Breaking the top.
There she is. Oh!
There it is, we got her up.
We got us a dinghy. Look at that.
Very nice job, Chuck. I'm glad I brought you along.
Well, you guys got her up. Now we just got to get her dry.
The easy part was over. We got the boat off the bottom. The hard part is actually getting it floating again. We've got to take all the water from the inside of the boat, which Costly wants to push it back down, to the outside of the boat.
Start pumping. There you go, Chuck.
So what you have is you have a boat that is sitting at the waterline. We have wave action that's bringing water over the side, so now we're teeter-tottering a boat left and right to prevent the water coming in from the top. It's a strategic game of cat and mouse with Mother Nature.
We're looking good. It's starting to look like a boat again. She's floating. See if you can jump in. Counter to the left. There you go.
We got some signs of scorching on the front side of this engine. It looks like the pistons kind of blew out.
When we finally got the motor out and inspected it, you could definitely tell there was some type of fire in this engine. There was some charring. Some of the hoses were melted. I really couldn't 100% say that it was a methane explosion. But something lit on fire in this engine before it went underwater.
Boat's looking good. She's all tied up. Just keep her slow. We'll do a troll and a roll.
Well, guys, that was a lot of work.
You ain't lying.
You know, a couple of things. One, we didn't necessarily, you know, prove that Mark's boat was blown up by methane gas.
It kind of looks like there was a fire. I mean, the engine had some scars and some signs of maybe something hot back there. But those old engines have been known to, have catastrophic failures every once in a while.
Dude, but we did find Mark's dinghy.
Yeah, but that engine was like an antique, bro. I mean, it's older than I am. I mean, of course the thing blew up.
I tell you what, that's an awesome looking old engine.
You know what we did today, guys? We took something back from the Triangle.
Yes, we did.
She's going to be
She's going to be ready to take something once again.
It's time to get out of here, then.
Time to head for the barn, guys.
Let's go.
Nice job, everybody.
Good work,
nice
job. Dave, good work.
Sorry, brother.
Good
sorry.
Work. Nice job, Mike. Hey, Chuck, good work. I'm going to tell you something else besides taking something back from the Triangle.
What?
Did it consistently and persistent.
We did. We did it very consistently.
Hey, somebody set that tow watch. I'm going to stay here at the helm. I'm going to keep it as nice, easy pace.
She's coming up.
Let me know if we start to bury the bow.
Everybody hang on. Coming up.
Although the damage to the dinghy is consistent with a methane explosion, years spent underwater have erased any evidence that could conclusively corroborate the witness's story.
After compiling the evidence that we have so far, I'm still leaning towards the fact that methane would have been the catalyst for the Cyclops blowing up. I think we still need to do a lot more investigation on this and maybe try to find a different angle.